हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। वेलकम टू केमिस्ट्री क्लास एंड वेलकम टू द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर थर्मोडायनेमिक्स, इन विच वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट जीरोथ लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। द जीरोथ लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज लॉ ऑफ थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम एंड द लॉ इज प्राइमरी इंपॉर्टेंस एंड मे बी स्टेटेड एज फॉलोज। इफ टू सिस्टम्स आर इन द थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम विद अ थर्ड सिस्टम देन दे मस्ट ऑल्सो बी इन थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम विद ईच अदर। मीन्स इफ देर आर टू सिस्टम विच आर इन थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम बट द थर्ड सिस्टम विच इज नॉट इन थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम बट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू दीज टू द थर्ड विल ऑल्सो बिहेव एज अ थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम। सो इट इज नोन एज अ जीरोथ लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। इफ अ बॉडी कैपिटल ए इज थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम विद अ बॉडी कैपिटल सी, अ थर्ड बॉडी B is also in thermal equilibrium with the body C, then the bodies A and B will also be in thermal equilibrium with each other, which is stated in these figures. You can see here zeroth law of thermodynamics. B and C are in thermal equilibrium, but A is not, but in with respect to B and C, this will also behave as a thermal equilibrium. What is the significance of zeroth law? The zeroth law of thermodynamics provides the operational definition of temperature which does not depends on hotness or coldness and make the concept of temperature more precise. So actually zeroth law of thermodynamics tells about the precision of the temperature. Okay, now first law of thermodynamics. So statements of first law. So according to the first law, energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, although it can be converted from one form to another. Okay, this is the first statement, and according to the second statement, the total energy of an isolated system remains constant, although it may be changed from one form to another. Okay, so if there is a change from one form to another form, but the total energy change will be same. Okay, now next point is the total energy of the universe is constant. It is also a third statement of first law of thermodynamics. Fourth statement, whenever a quantity of some form of energy disappears, an exactly equivalent amount of some other forms of energy must be produced. Okay, so these are the statements of the first law of thermodynamics. Now come to the internal energy and internal energy change. So as mentioned earlier, the physical and chemical change are usually accompanied by the energy change. The evolution of absorption of energy in physical and chemical change is possible only when substance is associated with definite amount of energy, and means the minimum amount of energy which is acquired by any system is known as the internal energy of that system. Okay, and internal energy is represented by symbol capital U and capital E. Okay, so the total amount of energy associated with a fixed amount of substance under a given set of conditions is referred as the internal energy or intrinsic energy of that substance. Thus capital U equals to UT plus UJ plus UV plus UN, means all type of the internal energy, sum of all type of internal energy of a substance is known as the total amount of energy, that is known as the internal energy. Okay, now internal energy change. So change is represented by delta and internal energy U. So internal energy change will be denoted by delta U or delta E. Okay, internal energy is a state function. What is a state function? The system which depends upon its initial and final condition, not on the path, is known as the state function. So change in energy or change in enthalpy, change in internal energy is also a state function. Means it only depends upon the initial. This means that change in internal energy आर डिपेंड्स अपॉन ओनली ऑन द इनिशियल एंड फाइनल स्टेट ऑफ द सिस्टम एंड नॉट अपॉन द इंटरमीडिएट स्टेट. Therefore, while determining the value of delta U, we are not concerned the path or the way by which a system transits from one state to another state. Okay, the change in internal energy is defined as the difference in the internal energy of the system in final and in initial state. Means delta U equals to U final state minus U initial state. Okay. So when a chemical reaction occurs, the internal energy of system before the reaction is usually different from the internal energy after the reaction. Okay, and for a reaction, for change in the internal energy in the chemical reaction is given by delta U equals to internal energy of product minus internal energy of reactant. You can also represent it delta U equals to UP minus UR. Okay, so it where UP represents internal energy of product and UR represents internal energy of reactants. Okay. Now, mathematical formulation of the first law of thermodynamics. So, the internal energy of the system can be changed into the following two ways. Number one, either by the allowing the heat flow into the system or out of the system. And number two, by the work done on the system or the work done by the system. Means on the system or by the system. Okay, so suppose the internal energy of system under a particular set of condition is U1. Suppose Q amount of heat is supplied to the system. Thus, this will increase the internal energy of the system from U1 to U1 plus Q. Q is heat supplied to the system. If the work W is done on the system, then the internal energy of the system will further increase. And if the internal energy of the system in the final state is U2, then the relation will come U2 equals to U1 plus Q plus W. U2 minus U1 equals to Q plus W, or finally you will get delta U equals to Q plus W. Means change in internal energy will be equal to heat supplied to the system plus work done. Okay. So, it is the mathematical expression for the first law of thermodynamics. Now, change in internal energy equals to heat supplied to the system plus work done of the system. It is the definition according to this equation. Now, equation 6.11 provides the relationship between change in internal energy of the system, heat supplied to the system and work done on the system, and is regarded as mathematical statement of the first law of thermodynamics. Okay, so with the help of question 6.11, following conclusions can be derived. If W is equal to 0 and Q delta U equals to Q, this implies that if no work is done on the system, then the change in internal energy is equal to the heat absorbed by the system. Means when work done is 0, then that condition will come. In second condition, delta U equals to 0 and Q equals to minus W. Thus, the internal energy of system does not change when the work done by the system is equal to the heat absorbed by the system. Okay. Number third condition, if the work done small W is the work of the expansion and have W equals to minus P delta V. And substituting the value of this W in equation 6.11, we get delta U equals to Q minus P delta V. And Q equals to delta U plus P delta V. And if the process is carried out under the constant volume of condition, means delta V equals to 0, then the equation QV equals to become delta U. So where QV signifies the heat absorbed by the system is constant at constant volume. Okay. Equation 3.16.13 implies that under constant volume and constant temperature condition, the change in internal energy of system is equal to the heat absorbed by the system. Hence, delta U is regarded as the measure of heat absorbed or evolved in a process occurring at constant volume and constant temperature. Okay, so neither Q nor W are state function. At the sum of the two delta, that is Q plus W, is a state function, because delta U is a state function, and the substances which are a state function will depend only on its initial and final condition, not at the path. Okay. Thank you and have a nice day.